Buckle up, Buttercup. It's Pittsburgh Sports Talk, and your Pittsburgh Penguins are back-to-back Stanley Cup champions. And guess what comes with that? A parade. It is a beautiful day in downtown Pittsburgh. It is a sweltering, I don't know, maybe 140 degrees, but none of these people care. 400,000 people have crammed into downtown Pittsburgh to celebrate your Pittsburgh Penguins. Well, bring in Lord Stanley's Cup one more time.
The Stanley Cup will be heading to Pittsburgh after Game 6, one way or another. And the Penguins hope the Cup is a passenger on their team flight. But the reigning champs are 0-3 this postseason in their first chance to close out a series, while teams who suffer a loss of at least 6 goals, as Nashville did in Game 5, are 3-0 in their subsequent games.
Dealt back along now for the pitch back out by Aubert. They picked across, carried on by Fisher, given across to Wilson, and a shot is covered there from Josi's stick by Matt Murray. Around this one goes near Gensel, then back behind it, poked in front, Sherry, a shot, and that one kicked down and then played right back ahead. A good block there. Pass ahead to Mike Fisher, gave it back across. Wilson to Fisher, spins one. Play to the outside by Neal, handed on over for a shot in front, off goal, and covered by Murray, and the whistle is blown.
Just a mad scramble. Great strength from Matt Murray of keeping that puck away from the goal line. It misfired on a couple of quality chances.
Centering pass on! What a save made by Matt Murray! A pad stop on a lightning-like shot that came from Aubert. Now it's Forsberg! Save! Puckley scores! Sisson's goal may not count.
And clearly the puck was never frozen. But again, the official lost sight of it. Well, there's the official, and again, look at his positioning. The puck ends up on the opposite side. He can't see that the puck is loose on the opposite side where he is.
The whistle had gone, we have no goal.
Hoping to poke it along was Wilson, who was covering. Now Crosby starts ahead, angles it on, and here comes Hagelin through the legs. Crosby, save made by Rene. Balkan dropped it off. Kessel with it there. Delays, can't get through. Penguins in the midst of a change. Sisson's moving on, and save made by Murray. Plopped right back in, and Yarncroke goes to get it. Brushed it around behind for centering pass, and Arvidsson's shot is into the glove of Murray. Brushed along by Ellis, but taken there and centered right front, and it ricocheted off of Pecorino. Another shot ricocheted off the pipe. Right back along, it's Dumoulin again. Then Hainsey, a shot out of the glove, but then covered by Rene. Sidney Crosby hits the line. Got it over to Cole, and a shot is grabbed and held by Rene. Wilson out there as well as Fisher. Jammed around in a lot of traffic, two aside the battle. Four kicking along, and a penalty is coming up.
I believe it's going to be on Trevor Daly for a punch to the face of Ryan Ellis.
Two defensemen in the penalty box, Mata and Daly. Then Josi, then Subban, then Josi, Subban, Josi, getting a piece of it with the glove with Murray. They got it out, front back scramble there. They continue to poke away, and Murray's got his glove on it.
This is an instant classic. I mean, the goaltending performance by both these men has been phenomenal.
Inside the diamond is Neal. It's fed back over to Yarncroke, then back to Ekholm, and a shot turned back out. Rebound right into Murray, and he covers.
38 in yellow. Rebound off a skate, and there he wasn't able to follow through because of the stick by Chris Kunitz.
Kunitz tries to shake through and cannot. Dealt around behind by Ellis. Arriving first is Kunitz. Kunitz to the outside, got it back to Schultz, and a shot went wide. Rebound off the boards. They score! The Penguins have scored. It is Hornquist. A bounce off the boards was shaken in. And Hornquist, who has not played a lot in the game, made the most of the time that time, and it's 1-0.
Nashville is using their coach's challenge for goaltender interference.
Is Pecorine allowed to play his position? So what they would be looking at is the contact with the left pad as Patrick Hornquist goes back to play that puck.
There is no goaltender interference. We have a good goal.
course, back off the boards, and Subban can't catch up to it. Along comes Hagelin, moving on in. He scores! Hagelin with 13.6 to go, and the Penguins celebrate at the bench. They almost clocked their coach, Mike Sullivan, with the stray sticks. A turnaround shot that rattled wide. Subban, one more try, deflected over the net, and the Pittsburgh Penguins again are the Stanley Cup champions. The coaches, both American-born, for the first time in Stanley Cup history, congratulate one another. Some slaps on the shoulders, and they move on. The Predators salute their fans one last time.
For only the third time, the Conn Smythe Trophy is being awarded to the same person two times in a row. Sidney Crosby, you are the playoffs MVP. In our 100th year and the 125th year of the Stanley Cup, it's only fitting that a team that for the first time in almost two decades has been able to hoist it. Congratulations to the Pittsburgh Penguins and their great fans back in Pittsburgh.
The Pittsburgh Penguins become the first back-to-back Stanley Cup champions since the Detroit Red Wings in 1998, winning the cup for the fifth time overall. Sidney Crosby joins Mario Lemieux and Bernie Parent as the only back-to-back winners of the Conn Smythe Trophy. This was the first Stanley Cup final since 1983, which did not have a one-goal game. Mike Sullivan becomes the first ever U.S.-born head coach to win two Stanley Cups. Matt Murray, a two-time Stanley Cup champion while still technically a rookie,